嗨，大家好，我是李贝。All right, let's continue reading《猫城记》。Okay, where were we? We got to the cat city, right? We got to the cat city, and what happened? A whole bunch of kittens died, and we found that Xiaoxie and a kitten named Mi were kind of doing their thing. They're kind of living together, falling in love. Other than that, I don't know. I forget. This is how I end up giving up on novels. I just forget what was going on. Yeah, and even though it's like a day or two ago I read this, that's why I almost never complete novels. Not that I don't consider it a valuable exercise, more that I just forget. 我没和小谢说，明说，明说，is that really a word？明说，is it not 说明？他也没留我，留我，what does 留我 mean？可是我住在那里了。Alright，so this is at the cultural center, right？第二天，我开始观察的工作，观察的工作。This is like a job as a someone who observes。先看什么？我并没有一定的计划。出去遇见什么，便看什么，似乎是最好的方法。在街的那边。我没看见过，多少小孩子？原来小孩子都在街的这边呢。我心里喜欢呢，猫人总算有什么一点好处，没忘了教育他们的孩子。街这边，既然都是文化机关，小孩子自然是来上学的。All right, so this is the cultural center slash school. 猫小孩是世界上最快活的小人们。世界上，What does 世界上 mean when the novel is set on Mars? 火星上。脏，非常的脏。形容不出的那么脏、瘦、臭、丑、缺鼻短眼的，我说 what that means，满头满脸，长疮了，the 疮 is like ulcer or something like this，so I'm guessing their face is covered in。Like sores or something like this. 可是都非常的快活。我看见一个脸上肿得像大肚罐子似的，嘴已肿得张不开，腮上许多血痕。他也居然带着笑容，也。还和别的小孩一块跳一块跑，我心里那点儿喜欢弃权。What's 弃权？喜欢弃权飞到天外去了。我不能把这种小孩子和美好的家庭学校联想到一处，快活。正因为家庭、学校、社会、国家全是糊涂蛋，糊涂蛋，OK，才会养成这样糊涂的孩子们，才会养成这种脏、瘦、臭、丑、缺鼻短眼的，可是还快活的小孩子。All right, so the children are happy in this place, but But they have these kind of things, these traits. Okay, so dirty, skinny, smelly, ugly. And what is chirpy duanyan? I don't know what that means. Chirpy duanyan. You have no nose and you have short eyes. Chirpy duanyan. Chirpy. Chirpy duanyan. Bees, bees, the bee. Duan. Oh? No. Not Duan, but Duan. Why is it? Did you see? Oh, sorry, you can't see. If I move over here, it puts Duan. Duan. No, Duan. No, it's Duan, not Duan. Duan. Where's Duan? Alright. What were the characters again? This is taking a lot longer than I was expecting. Shama shamda. Chue bi. Beads. Alright, it's not in there. Chue bi duan yan. Shall we Google it? Have I got Google ready? Chue bees. Oop. Chue bees. Duan yan. All right, what you got for me? Ooh. Yeah, Google is like this. All right, maybe we'll keep reading while we're waiting for Google. All right, where were we? Kush, hi, quite hard as your head. Oh, so that. Jujun, hi, this is Shohei Gordia the Soyin. 是成人们的惩罚者. What is soying? Soying. Saw search in attract. Soying. Index. Maybe this one. Bring together. It must be that one, right? The other one doesn't really make sense. Well, Google is now firing. It looks, this is the book, right? So I will copy that so I can search. This isn't loading. Why isn't it loading? Okay, I know what I'm doing wrong. One second. Yeah, so this is just the book, right? If you want to read along with me, there it is. Seems like you can just Google it. I don't know. Chibi Duanyan. The kittens were the happiest people. I don't know. Maybe it just describes their physical features. It seems like it's not a Chongyu, it's just Lao Shu's vernacular or Lao Shu's way of using words. Okay, 他们长大成人的时候不会使国家不脏不臭不丑。 我又看见那... Oh, my stuff is here. 我又看见了那... 毁灭的... Can I make that bigger? 毁灭的巨植按在 这群猫国的希望上, 没希望... 多妻自由联合, 只管那么着, 没人, 没人肯替他们, 种族, 他的种族想一想, 爱的生活在毁灭的巨植下, 讲爱的生活, 不知死的鬼。 All right, whatever that means. I don't think that's essential. 我先不要呼蒙的下段语，还是先看了再说话吧。我跟着一群小孩走，来到一个学校，一个大门，四面墙围着，一块空地，小孩都进去了，我在门外看着，小孩子有的在地上滚成一团，小孩子有的这样，有的在往墙上爬，有的在墙上画图，有的在墙角细细检查彼此的秘密。都很快，没有先生。So 先生 here would be a teacher, I guess, or like an adult supervisor of some kind. 我等不了，只有多久？来了三个大人，他们都瘦得像鼓楼标题。No, 标本，标本 ，like a skeletal specimen. 好似自从生下来就没吃过一顿饱饭。走扶着墙慢慢的增，每逢有一阵小风，他们便立足哆嗦半天。他们慢慢的增进校门，孩子们叫就滚，爬闹，看秘密。三位坐在地上，张着嘴喘气，孩子们闹得更厉害。他们三位全闭上眼，堵上耳朵，似乎唯恐得罪的学生们，唯恐得罪。So they're not afraid of other things, right? 又过了不知多少时候，三位一起立起来，劝孩子们坐好。学生们似乎是下了决心，永不坐好。又过了大概至少有一点钟吧，还是没坐好。进而三位先生，他们必定是先生了，一眼看见了我。门外有外国人，只有这么一句，小孩子全面朝墙坐好，没有一个敢回头的。All right, interesting. So yeah, so there's three 先生. So I believe 先生, like we translate it to Mr. in English.But I don't believe it's as gendered as that implies. So 先生, I believe, can also be female in Chinese. I'm not 100% sure on that. But remember, this book was written 92 years ago as well, right? Maybe even more than that. Published 92 years ago. So that was the language back then. So things have changed. 三位先生的中间，那一位大概是校长，他发了话。All right, so that one's a guy. 第一项唱国歌，谁也没唱，大家都愣了一会儿。校长又说，第三项向皇上行礼，谁也没行礼。大家都愣了一会儿，向大神默起，这个时候学生们似乎把外国人忘了，开始你挤我，我挤你。All right, so the instructor told them to sing the national anthem.I don't know what the national anthem of the cat country on Mars is. maybe I should go, ChatGPT, Can you make up a national anthem for the cat country on Mars? I'm kind of curious what it'll do that. What would it'll say? This one was, what is it? Salute the Emperor. And they didn't do that either. But silently pray to God. And then they did that really with gusto, right? Why? Wait, that is, yeah, that's what 彼此, 叫骂起来, 有外国人,大家又安静了, 校长训话, 校长向前迈了一步, 向大家的脑勺子说, 今天是诸位在大学毕业的日子。 So what's my pointer? 就是, 这么光荣的事本, 尸体. Oh well. 我几乎要, 晕过去, 就, 凭这样, 这群大学毕业, 但是我先别动情感, 好好的听着吧。 校长, 继续地说, 诸位在这最高学府毕业, 是, 何等光荣的事, 诸位在这里毕业, 什么事都明白了, 什么知识都有了, 以后, 国家的大事, 便, 全要放在诸位的肩头上, 是何等的光荣的事。 校长打了个, 长而有条的, 呵欠。 完了。 What is 呵欠? What? I don't know. 哈欠。 Is it 哈欠? Like a yawn? 完了。 Why did he say 完了? Oh, that's the end of his speech, maybe. 校长继续地说, 两位教员拼命的鼓掌，学生又闹起来，外国人安静了，外国人安静了，教员训话，两位先生谦逊了半天，结果一位脸瘦的像个干。 什么瓜？围瓜？倭瓜？ I don't know. 是的，先生向前迈了一步。 我看出来这位先生是个悲观者。 因为, 眼角挂着两点, 大泪珠, 他极哀婉地说。 Alright, let's see what the pessimistic instructor, who looks like they're about to cry, is going to say.
诸位, 今天, 在这最高学, 最高学府毕业, 是何等光荣的事, 他的泪珠落下了一, 落下一个来。 我们国立的学校都是最高学府, 是何等光荣的事, 又落下一个, 泪珠来。 诸位, 请不要忘了, 校长和, 教师的好处, 我们能做诸位的教师是何等的光荣, 但是昨天我的妻子饿死了。
Alright, that changed in tone all of a sudden. What? So we're at this like graduation ceremony, and the teacher's like, "Yesterday, my wife died of starvation." Like, it's just such a so out of place, right?
她的泪像雨点般落下。 挣扎了半天，他才又说出话来。诸位别忘了教师的好处，有钱的帮点钱，有钱的帮点钱，有迷业的帮点迷业。 诸位大概都知道，我们已经25年没有薪水了。
Really？
诸位，他不能再说了。一歪身坐在地上，把证书。
Yeah, so right, that teacher's on the verge of a mental breakdown. I'm laughing. It's like, all right. It's just like, why would you be giving graduation prizes when your wife died of starvation yesterday? Maybe don't do that.
校长从墙根搬起些薄石片来，石片上大概是刻了鞋字，我没有十分看清。校长把石片放在脚前，说：“此次毕业，大家都是第一，何等的光荣！现在证书放在这里，诸位，随便来拿。因为大家都是第一，自然不必分 ，no。”自然不必分钱，
我
不必分前后的次序。
Ah, okay. We don't know. Don't need to go in before and after order.
散会。
So, all right, we're done. that was bizarre.
校长和那位。先生把地下，我把地下坐着的悲观者，搀起，慢慢地走出来。学生并没去拿证书，大家又上墙，滚地的滚啊，上墙的上墙，滚地的滚地，闹成一团。什么把戏呢？我心中要糊涂死。回去问小仙。
Yeah, that was really confusing. Alright, I'm glad I'm not the only one who thought that was really confusing. Like, they're at a graduation ceremony. One of the teachers comes out, it's like, yeah, my wife starved to death yesterday. Don't forget your teachers. And like, nobody collected their certificates. What?
It made no sense to me. 小谢和米都出去了，我只好再去看。看完一总问他吧。在刚才看过的学校斜旁边又是一外学校，学生大概都在十五六岁的样子，有七八个人在地上。按着一个人
on the ground. What does that mean? Like, is an like amor, maybe massage? I don't know.
用一些家伙，割 pole?
No, 不是 pole,
割什么？割什么呢？
What's that character? 割I feel like I know that character.
So, 割, it's 割草的割。
割草。Not to sing about grass, but 割。How do I... It's not pole, right? Oh, it is pole. 割 pole?
Yong 一些家伙。割剖呢
？What? So, 割 meaning to cut, 剖 meaning to dissect. What?
旁边还有一些学生正在捆两个人，这大概是学习生理解剖，我想。
Pole? Is there a meaning of pole that I don't know? analyze, but that doesn't make sense. 解开，破开. Could it mean analyze? 解剖? 解剖 here is analyze, right? So, 实习生, no, but this is 理解. 理解剖. It's not, yeah, it's not. Oh, no, it's not. I got the passing wrong, the segmentation wrong. All right.
这里大概是学习生理解剖.
Yeah, 实习 here is a verb. Yeah, 实习生 is a word in Chinese, but it's not, that's not the word here. Oh. 理解. Okay. Okay, so in this class, they're practicing 解剖, dissection. So, okay, this makes more sense now. So there's like a dead body or something on the ground and they're cutting it open. And I'm thinking, ah, oh, they're studying dissection in class. Okay, makes more sense now.
不过把活人滚起来,滚起来,解剖未免太残忍了。
Are you telling me that they're still alive and you're performing dissection on them? Okay.
我硬着心看着，到底要看个水落石穿，一会儿的功夫，大家把那两个人捆绑捆绑捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆捆 吓死过去。那些铁铺的一边，歌仔一边叫骂。
歌仔，仔 is used for slaughtering, like animals, like when you want to kill a sheep to produce lamb. Yeah, you'll die. yeah, this has gotten really wacky. All right.
看他还管咱们不管你各死东西，你各死东西，扔出一只胳膊来叫我们念书不许教惹女学生。社会黑暗到这里还叫我念书。还不许在学校里那么着挖你的心。你个死东西，鲜红的一块飞到空中。
So they're arguing with each other, right? It's like, here, have an arm. While I perform a live dissection. And when I say live, I mean the patient.
把那两个死东西捆好了抬过一个来。抬校长还是历史教员。校长 ,what?
What?
抬校长。
Wait, are we going to, like, tie up and dissect the principal and the history teacher? What? I'm so confused.
我的心要从口中跳出来了。原来这是解剖校长与教员。
Okay, you know, like, I'm confused, but literally, that's what it says. I interpreted it correctly. I think I'm meant to be confused.I read it correctly, and it's like, yeah, that's what it says. We're going to dissect the principal and teachers.
All right. 也许校长教员早就该杀 ，All right， 但是我不能看着学生们大宰活人。我不管谁是谁，谁是谁非，从人道上想，我不能看着学生们或许何人随便行凶。他我把手枪掏出来了，其实我喊了一声他们也就全跑了，但是我真动了气，我觉得这群东西只能以手枪对待，其实他们哪值得一枪呢？ What's that? Bang. Some kind of onomatopoeia? 我放了一枪 okay, so it's another bullet. 划了四面的墙全倒了下来。All right. 大雨后的墙是受不住震动的。我又做了一件错事想救校长，把校长和学生全砸在墙底了。我心中没有声音，就是杀校长的学生也是一条命，我不能甩手一走。但是怎样就这么些人幸而墙只有土堆成的，我不知道进来心中怎么这样卑鄙。All right. So I was really confused. I was like, what? Are they really going to dissect the principal and or history teacher? That's what it said. I'm questioning my sanity there for a second. But that's what it said. So I went to rescue them. All right. So in order to rescue them, I shot my gun. I shot my gun and the wall, which was, what's the word? Unstable from the rains, had collapsed. And yeah, I couldn't just, sort of sit there and do nothing.
在这白茫中似乎想到，校长大概确实该杀。
Okay. Well, there goes my moral standing all of a sudden.
看这校址的建筑把钱他全自己挣了去，而只用些土堆成围墙，办学校的而私吞公款。Geisha.
All right. That was a very quick judgment. All right. So, having shot the gun to protect the principal from being live dissected, the wall collapsed and discovered, this principal's been taking all the money for the school, and it's very dangerous. Therefore, I declare that he should die. That's a bit of a rash decision. Yeah.
虽然是这么猜想，我可是手脚没闲着，连拉带扯。
Yeah, do you know this grammar structure? There's quite a few, chongyu, maybe, I don't know if you call it chongyu,
连什么带什么。
So 连 verb, 带 verb, that sort of thing. So you're doing two actions at the same time. So this is just one example of a whole family of words. And I don't even think you have to use single character words, single character verbs as well.
我很快地拉出许多人来，每方拉出一个
土鬼，
连看我一眼也不看，便疯了似的跑去。 All right, so, okay, so the walls are collapsing on all the cats, students. The cat people students. I'm rescuing them, and then they're like, take one look at me and run away.
像是有龙里往外 逃放生的鸽子似的 并没有受重伤的 我心中 不但舒坦的 而且 学的那 这个把 这个把戏 很有趣 最后把校长和 教员也掏出来，他们的手脚全捆着呢，所以没跑。我把他们放在一旁，开始用脚各处的踢。Wait,
I'm kicking them.
看土里边还有人没有？
Oh, no, I'm kicking the soil. I'm not kicking them. Okay.
大概是没有了。可是我又踢了一遍, 却乎觉得是没有人了。我回来把两位 捆着的土鬼都松了绑。
All right. So these two teachers that have been tied up and they were going to be dissected, I've now released them. They also got buried in the soil as well. Okay. This really is a change of tone from what was happening before in the story.
待了好大半天,两位先生睁开了眼,我手下没有一些救急的药和 安神社气的酒类安全酒也只好看着他们两个虽然我急于问他们好多试验可是我不忍得立刻问他们两位先生慢慢地坐起来眼睛不带着惊慌的神气我向他们一挥
我向他们一微笑, 低声地问,
哪位是校长?
Yeah, all right, what's going on? Presumably we're going to figure out what's going on. Which one's the principal? Let's figure that out first.
两人脸上, 带出十二分害怕的, 十二分害怕的样子。
This is the second time we got this in this book, right?
十二分.
Usually in you say 万分, 十分. This is 十二分.
彼此互相举例举.
Hijinks, we have hijinks.
神经错乱了，我想.
Hijinks.
两位先生偷偷地慢慢地轻轻地 往起站 我没动 我以为他们是要活 活动现场 他们立起来 彼此一点头 就好像两个 雌雄相逐的青蛙 在眼前飞过那么快
蜻蜓 sorry 蜻蜓 not 青蛙 蜻蜓 dragonfly
alright 一眨眼的功夫 两位先生已跑出老远 追是没用的 和猫人竞走 我是没希望得胜的 我叹了一口气 坐在土堆上.
All right, so I, as a reader, do not know what's going on, but yeah, this is the story. It's a story, so I think I'm not meant to know what's going on in the story just yet. The author is giving us these clues that something weird is going on. There's some kind of a societal function which involves dissecting people live and this sort of thing. 怎么一回事呢?
谁是校长？他们彼此举例举，刚活过命，来变相牺牲别人而保全自己。他们以为我是要加害于校长，所以彼此举例举，偷偷的、慢慢的立起来，向倾听飞跑了去。哈哈，我狂笑起来，我不是笑他们两个，我是笑他们的社会。 楚楚的疑心冒小，自立，残忍，没有一点诚实，大量义气，慷慨。学生解剖校长，校长不敢承认自己是校长。<笑>黑暗，黑暗，100分的黑暗。难道他们看不出我救了他们？黑暗的社会里。 哪有救人的事？我想起公使太太和那八个小妖精，他们大概还在那里臭烂着呢。All right,
so I'm reflecting on what just happened. I find this society very silly. Dissecting your principal.
校长先生教员。 公使太太，八个小精妖精，什么叫人生？我不由得落了泪。到底什么回事？想不出，还得去问小仙。Yeah,
I don't know either. All right, it's not just me. The protagonist doesn't know. It's not related to my language skills. It's related to the author going, you know what? I'm going to keep this back and leave you in suspense. All right, pause for a second. I need the bathroom. All right. Okay.
下面是小谢的话.
All right, here we go. Let's figure out what is going on. Why are we dissecting the principle?
在火星上. 各国还是野蛮人的时候，我们已经有了教育制度。猫国是个古国，可是，我们的现行教育制度是由外国抄袭来的。这并不是说我们不该什么防别人。
What's that character? I don't know. Huh? Grass sun, is it grass sun big hand? All right. Oops. Let's put it in. Grass sun big hand. More. More fun. Ah, it's an alternative character, is it? A variant character? This one, variant of Morfang. So I don't think it's maybe, oh sorry. Yeah, variant of Morfang.
现在规范词协作模仿.
Yeah, this is the one I was taught, Morfang. So this is just another way of writing Morfang. Or maybe it was the correct way of writing it when when Lao Shu wrote it. All right, Morfang.
Yeah, 但是假如我们
No, this more fun.
这并不是说我们不该模仿别人，而是说取法别人并不是件容易的事，互相模仿是该 当的，而且是人类文明改进的一个重要动力。
没有人采行我们的老制度，而我们必须学别人的新制度。这一见出谁高谁低。但是假如我们能模仿得好，使我们的教育与别国的并驾齐驱，我们自然便不能算十分低能。我们实行新教育制度与方法已经200多年，可是依然一塌糊涂。这证明我们连模仿也不会，自己原有的记性不开，学别人又学不好。我是个悲观者，我承认我们的民族的底能。So, cat society is trying to, they use the term 抄袭. 抄袭 is plagiarize. So 抄袭, plagiarize. There's another meaning. Okay. Emulate indiscriminately or copy. Okay, so this meaning. Where's the Chinese one? It'll be this first one, right? 照抄别人的著作或作业等当做自己的。Maybe it's this one. 机械的搬用别人的经验方法的。Yeah, this one. 抄袭。So the cat people are like, oh, the wagger and do it like that, so we'll do it like that. But according to Xiao Xie, the cat people's 模仿 is not very good. Their ability to imitate is not very good. Hence, they end up dissecting the principle. There are a few steps in between there. I'm not good at imitating, but I want to imitate. Anyway, 底能民族的革新是个笑话。Alright. So this sounds very English. Like, it's a real joke. Yeah. 我们的新教育所以也是个笑话。所以 So this is 所以 is this. Yeah. 因为所以 Yeah. If I wrote like that, my teacher would put my 所以 here. Yeah, I don't know. I kind of like it like this better. I might use 由此 or 因此. My teacher would correct me. I don't have a teacher, but I kind of imagine having a teacher who's correcting me. What would my teacher say? 我问为什么一点的小孩子便在大学毕业？我太诚实了，或者应说大傻了。我不知道那是个笑话吧。毕业，那些小孩都是第一天入学的，要闹笑话就爽的闹到家。我们没有其他可以自傲的事，只有能把笑话闹得彻底。You know what? I was reading that. I wasn't paying attention. What is it? I was just thinking about something else. It's on autopilot. This is the problem with reading, isn't it? Like, if I read quietly, I will just like my eyes will look at the words and my brain will register them or something like this, and I'll just think about something else entirely. This is why I read aloud. If I read aloud, yeah, sure, it's a bit slower, but I actually pay attention to what is said. But unfortunately, maybe as my as my reading aloud is improving, I don't even have to pay attention anymore. Like, I have no idea what they just said. Let's read it again.
我问为什么一点的小孩子便在大学毕业，你太诚实了，或者硬说大傻了。你不知道那是个笑话吗？ 毕业，那些小孩都是第一天入学的。
Okay. So, what? So everything is totally bizarre on this planet now. So why were they dissecting their principal? No, I didn't get to the dissection part. Why were they having a graduation ceremony? And it's like, graduation ceremony? No, that was their first day of school. Already dissecting the principal. All right.
Okay. 要闹笑话就爽的闹到家，我们没有其他可以做的事，只有能把笑话闹得彻底。这过去200年的教育史，就是笑话史。现在这部笑话史已到了末页，任凭谁怎么聪，怎样聪明，也不会再把这个大笑话弄得再可笑一点。
What? The more I read this, the harder it gets. It's not the words, it's understanding what's going on on this planet. So is Xiaoxie using the word xiaohua, joke, like a joke? Is he using xiaohua as a metaphor, like meaning it's low quality, or is he meaning it literally? It's like these students are trying to pursue hilarity otherwise.
在新教育初施行的时候，我们的学校也分多少等级，学生必须一步一步的经过试验，而后才算毕业。经过200年的改革、改善与进步，考试慢慢的取消了，凡是个学生，不管他们上课与否。 到时候，总得算他毕业。可是小学毕业与大学毕业自然在身份上有个分隔，谁肯甘心落个小学毕业的资格呢？小学与大学既是一样的，不上课。
I need to phrase that as a question.
不上课，所以，我们彻底的改革了。凡是头一天入学的就先算他们在大学毕业，先毕业而后，没有而后，已经毕业了，还要什么而后？
All right, so. I don't know, we wanted all the students to do well or something like this. And so, like, on day one of primary school, we graduated them from university. And it's like, yeah, everyone does well. something in that ballpark.
这个办法是最好的，在猫国，在统计上。 我们的大学毕业生数目在火星上各国中算低。
Yeah, we're artificially inflating the statistics. So everyone graduates from university, the instant they go to school.
数目低，也就足以自慰，不自傲了。我们猫人是最，最重实际的。
The 重 means 重视 right?
你看，屈指一算 ，right? 屈指一算，哪一国的大学毕业生人数，也跟不上我们的。
Yeah, you're quite right. If they automatically graduate, if everyone like automatically graduates from university, you'd have very, very good statistics. Sometimes it is quite like that in the real world, isn't it? I guess we've got into a satire part.
你看，不不，事实，大家都满意的微笑了。All right.皇帝喜欢这个办法，要不是，他热心教育，怎能，有这么多大学毕业生？他对得起人民。教员喜欢这个办法，人人是大学，教师，每个学校都是最高学府，每个学生都是第一。
OK，
何等光荣！
Yeah, all right, so the emperor likes it because it's like, yeah, we have the best education system. All the students graduate. The teachers like it because it's like, yeah, well, my students are doing quite well. I must be a really good teacher. And the students like it because they all come first. Yeah, so we've gotten into the satire. So everyone's happy with it.And if you want to change it, you have to accept someone is not going to be happy.
家长喜欢这个办法。七岁的小女鬼，大学毕业，子弟聪明是父母的光荣。学生，更不必说了。只要他幸而生在猫国，只要他，不在六七岁的时期死了。他总可以，得一个大学毕业资格。从经济上看呢，这个办法更妙得出奇。No， 妙得出奇。原先在出办学校的时候，皇帝得年年拿出一笔，教育费。皇上 ，really？ 而，教育出来的学生，常和皇上反对为难。
All right，
这岂不是花钱找麻烦
？All right， so the emperor would， the emperor。Would have to pay all this money for education, and the result would be these people would be like arguing against the emperor, causing trouble. And it's like, why am I paying money to have all this trouble? Yeah, we're definitely deep into satire. This could be so 90 years ago, like people would still be remembering the end of the end of the Qing Dynasty, right? Yeah, there was a whole bunch of corruption and so on. So this is probably a satire pertaining to this kind of thing, I guess.
现在呢，皇上一个钱不要往外拿，而年年有许多大学毕业生，这样的毕业生也不会和皇帝，和皇上过
过不去。What does 过不去 mean? Oh, 就是超越. Yeah, this is not, cannot exceed the emperor. 饿死的教员, 自然不少。 大学毕业生人数可增加了呢? 原先, 校长教员, 因为挣钱, 一天到晚互相排挤, 天天, 总得打死几个。 而且有时候鼓动学生乱闹, 闹得大家不安。 现在皇上, 不给他们钱, 他们还争什么? 他们要锁心的皇上不理他们, 着急的皇上, 皇上便派兵打他们的脑勺, 他们的后盾是学生, 可是学生现在都一入学便毕业, 谁去再帮助他们呢? 没有人帮助他们闹事, 他们只好, 等着饿死, 饿死是老实的事, 皇上就是满意教师们饿死。 All right, so in this kind of dystopia, we have the teachers are like starving to death and so on. They don't really have much of a job. It's like day one, you graduate. Day one of primary school, you graduate university. The teachers, why would they, it was the parents who was getting them to cause trouble, right? Yeah, 鼓动学生乱闹. So who was it? So the teachers were asking this, like getting the students to cause trouble. Yeah, I'm not entirely sure how it all links together. However, we have a dystopia in which you enter the school and there's... You graduate. Everybody gets a university degree. You get a university degree, and you get a university degree.
家长的儿童, 教育费问题解决了, 他们只需, 把个小泥鬼送到学校里, 便算没了他们的事, 孩子们, 在家呢, 得吃饭, 孩子们入学校呢, 也得吃饭, 吃饭, 有饭吃, 谁肯饿着小孩子? 没饭吃呢, 小孩, 也得饿着, 上学, 与, 不上学的, 上学与不上学, 是一样的, 为什么, 不去来个大学毕业资格呢? 反正, 书笔和其他费用是没用的, 因为入学并不为读书, 并不为读书, 他就不读书, 因为, 因为得资格, 而且,
So this is 因为这个,所以这个, right?
也就不读书,因为得资格,而且必定得资格。你说这个方法好不好?
So confusing, but alright. So there's no real motivation for doing anything because the why not get your university degree the instant you go to primary school?
为什么还有人当校长与教员呢?
我问, 你问。 Oh, okay, so this entirety is 小写. Why would people become university principals and school principals and teachers?
这得说二百年来历史的
历史的严谨。你看，在原先学校所设的课程不同，造就出来的人才也就不一样，有的学工，有的学商，有的学农。可是这些人毕业后干什么呢？学工的是学外国的一点技巧，我们没给他们预备下外国的工业，学商的是学外国的一些方法，我们只有些小判子 right 小判子 it's 背叛的叛 right betray no it's not so what is this character oh is it 贩卖的贩 yeah 贩卖的贩 so 小贩子Alright, so they get an education in commerce, but it doesn't mean anything, so they just end up selling random things.
大规模的事业自要一开张便被军人没收了。学农的是学外语的农业，我们只种米业。不种别的。这样的教育是学校与社会完全无关。学生毕业以后可干什么去？只有两条出路。
Sorry, can you see that?
做官与当教员。要做官的必须有点人情势力。不管你是学什么的，只要朝中有人便能一步登天，谁能都有钱有势呢？
What is 一步登天？一步登天。Okay, so 一步 one step 登天 ，like reach the sky. Maybe this is like a quick success kind of thing.
做不着官的，教书是次好的事业，反正受过新教育的是不甘心去做小工人、小贩子的。渐渐的，社会上分成两种人：学校毕业的和非学校毕业的。前者是抱定以做工做教员为职业，后者是做小工人小贩子的。这种现象对于政治的影响我今天先不说。对于
alright so maybe this is important you'll find out later in the story
对于教育呢，我们的教育变成了轮环教育。我念过书，我毕业后便去教你的儿女，你的儿女毕业了，又教我的儿女，在学识上永远是那一套东西，在人格上天天有些退步，在这怎样讲呢？毕业的越来越多了，除了几个能做官的，其余的都要教书，哪有那么多学校呢？只好闹笑话。OK， 只好闹笑话。Why? Hmm. OK， 轮黄教育本来只是为传授那几本不朽之作的教科书，并不讲什么仁义道德，所以为争一个教度，那我教习。教习，first time I've encountered that word。有时候，能引起12年的内战，杀人流血，好像大家真为教育事业拼命似的，其实只为那点薪水。Alright. Anyway, I think the moral we're meant to be, or not the moral. The idea we're meant to be taking is that we have this dystopian education system where everyone gets a free education and we dissect. We haven't figured out why we're dissecting principles. Let's figure this out. 慢慢的，教育经费被皇上、政客、军人都拿了去，大家开始专做琐心的运动。不去教书，学生呢看透了先生们是什么东西，也养成了养成了不上课的习惯哦，也养上了不上课的习惯。于是开始刚才，开始刚才我说的不读书而毕业的运动。Alright，这个运动断送了教育经费的命，皇上、政客、军人、家长全赞助这个运动，反正教育是没用的东西，而教员是无可敬畏的玩意。大家乐得省几个钱呢，但是学校不能关门，恐怕外国人耻笑。于是入学便算大学毕业的运动成熟了。学校教助开着，大学毕业人数日渐增加。可是一个钱不要花，这是由轮换教育改成普及教育，即等于无教育，可是学校还开着，天大的笑话。I think the joke is just him criticizing it, right? This kind of concept. So it evolved into this system where day one you get your certificate. 这个运动成熟的时候，做校长与教师的并不因此而减少对于教育的热心。大家还是一天到晚打得不可开交，打得不可开交。Yeah, just means you're busy, right? Yeah, usually do you know Genshin Impact? Kaya. There's a character, Kaya, in Genshin Impact, and he says, 忙得不可开交. Yeah, it's like very or something like this, I guess. 为什么原先的学校确实，哦，不好意思，原先的学校。确实像学校的样子，有桌椅，有财产，有一切的设备，有经费的时候，大家尽量挣钱。校长与教员只好开始私卖公产，争校长，校长少的争校产多了。没校产的，中有校产的，又打了个血花乱箭。皇上总是有人心的， 既停止了教育经费，怎在好意，怎在好意思禁止倒卖校产。于是学校一个一个的变成拍卖场。到了现在全变成四面墙围着一块空地。
So what's happening? Corruption. Like ridiculous levels of corruption. Like satirical levels of corruption. Yeah, so the teachers and principals are just selling whatever's in the school. And so it becomes empty. Okay. So that's why the walls collapsed when I shot my gun.
那么现在为什么还有人愿意做校长教员呢？
Yeah, why?
不干是闲置，干是也是闲置，何必不干呢？再说，有的校长教员，的名衔，到底是有用的。OK， 有学生升为教员，有教员升为校长。这本来是轮换教育的必尊之路。现在呢，校长教育既无钱可拿，只好借着这个头衔做升官的台阶 ，no， 阶梯，
阶梯，step ladder， right，
阶梯，这样我们学校里没教育，可是
sorry，
可是有学生，有教员，有校长，而且任何校学校都是最高学府。学生一听说自己的学校是最高学府，心眼里变麻那么一下，而后天下太平。What is 下太平？
Does Taiping refer to the Taiping Rebellion?
下太平，后天下。
Is that like a saying, maybe?
后天下太平。后天下太平。然后天下太平。
No, it's not related to Taiping Rebellion.Am I getting it wrong? Maybe I'm getting it wrong. Anyway. So here,
而后天下太平.
So here, everything's settled. All right. So we have this useless school, school in name only.And there's teachers and principals, and why are they doing it? Not to teach anything, they're doing it because they need the title and they can use the title to get ahead in life. Not because of any educational motivations.
学校里既没有教育，真要读书的人怎么办呢？恢复劳制制度，聘请家庭教师教师教子弟在家中念书，自然这只有富足的人家才能办到。大多数的儿童还是得到学校里去失学。失学
？What is 失学？
到学校里去失学。
What does that mean?
Shi. Yeah.
deprived of an education.
应该上学的青少年和儿童失去了上学的机会或中途
What is that character? 什么坠学对吗辍学
嗯
All right. Anyway, so they're going to school, but are still deprived of an education.
这个教育的失败把猫国的最后希望打得连银子也没有了。新教育的初一试行。试行是污蔑新学时的七天。时期。新制度必须与新学时一同由外国搬运过来。学时而名之曰新的。
Alright.
然而是学时劳在往前进展。
What is this? Is this like a saying or something?
学时而名之曰新的。日新月异。日新月异的搜求真理。可是新制度与新学时新学时到了我们这里便立刻长了白毛。像于天的东西发霉。
Alright.
本来嘛采取别人家的制度学时最容易像有别人身上割上一块肉不在自己身上。自己觉得只要从别人身上割来一块肉就够了。OK, 大家只管割取人家的心肉而不管肌肉所需的一切养分取来一堆新知识。也不晓得研究的精神势必走到轮环教育上去不可不是侮辱新知识可是在这个时期人们确实抱着一种希望虽然他们以为从别人身上割取一块新肉便会使自己长生不老的错误的。可是究竟他们有什么一点迷信？他们总以为只要新知识一到，不管是多么小的一点，他们立刻会与外国一样的兴旺起来。这个梦想与自傲还是可原谅的多少是有点希冀的到了现在人们只知道学校是争校长打教员闹风潮的所在于是他们把这个现象与新知识煮在一个锅里煮咒骂 No, 咒骂 right? 新知识不但不足以强国而且是毁人的我们他们想这样有污蔑新知识时期进而为咒骂新知识时期现在家庭聘请教师教读子弟新知识一概除外我们原有的老师透书的价钱曾涨了十倍我的祖父非常的得意因为这是我粹 我最战胜了外国学问，我的父亲高兴了，他把儿子送到外国读书，因为这么一办，只有他们的儿子可以明白一切，可以将来帮助他利用新知识去欺骗那些抱着石头书本的人。 父亲是精明强干的，他总以为外国的新知识是有用的，可是只要几个人学会便够了。Well,
all right, so... Yeah, I should have paused. So this new knowledge... So 新知识 would be knowledge brought by foreigners, I guess. Foreigners from other places in this case. Yeah, 我的父亲 was 大写, right? So this is 小写 speaking. Alright. So yeah, we don't need everyone to have the new knowledge.
有几个学会外国的把戏, 我们 便会强盛起来，可是一般的人还是同情于祖父。新知识是种魔术写法，只会使人头晕目眩，something
like that.
头晕目眩，只会使儿子打父亲，女儿骂母亲。 学生杀教学教员一点好处也没有，这祖玛新知识的时期，便离亡国时期很近了。
I'm still not really sure why they're dissecting people. Like they're all broke and so on and trying to make money and everyone's like doing things for dodgy reasons, not because there's no altruism here, let's put it that way.
你问，这新教育崩溃的原因如何？ 我回答不出，我只觉得是因为没有人格。你看，当新教育初一来到的时候。 人们为什么要他？是因为大家想多发一点财，而不是想教子弟多明白一点事，是想多造出点心儿好用的东西，不是想教人们多知道一些真理。 这个态度以使教育失去养成良好人格和启发研究精神的主宰的一部分。极致新学校成立了，学校里有人，而无人格教员为争前。 校长为争前，学生为预备争前，大家看学校是一种新式的饭铺，什么是教育？没有人过问，又赶上国家衰弱，社会黑暗，社会灰暗，皇上没有人格，政客没有人格。 民人民没有人格，于是，在学校外的没人格，又把学校里的没人格加料的，洗然了一番。自然，在这贫弱的国家里，许多人连吃还吃不饱。 是很难以讲道的人格，人格多半是由经济压迫而坠落的。不错， 但是这不足以作为教育的人们的辩护。为什么要教育救国？怎样救国？知识与人格，在这在办教育的时候便应打定主意。在这一院做校长教师的时候，便应该牺牲了自己的那点小利益。也许我对于办教育的人的期许过重了。期许
is it like 期待？
人总是人，一个教员正和一个妓女一样的怕挨饿。我似乎不应专责备教员，我也确乎不肯专责于他们。但是有的女人纵然挨饿也不肯当妓女，那么办教育的难道就是不能摇一摇牙做个有人格的人？自然政府是最受欺辱老实的人。办教育的人越老实便越受欺辱。可是无论怎样，不好的政府也要顾及点民意吧。假如我们办教育的真有人格，到处出的学生也有人格，社会上能永远瞎子眼看不出好坏呢？假如社会看办教育的人如慈父，而造就出的学生都能在社会上有些成就，政府敢轻视教育，敢不发经费，我相信有十年的人格教育，猫国便会变个样子。可是新教育已办了200年了，结果假如在老制度之下能养成一种老实受父亲爱父亲守规矩的人们，怎么新教育会没有相当的好成绩呢？人人说尤其是办教育的人们，社会黑暗把社会变白了是谁的责任？
So this kind of educational system is like full of corruption, but who can change it? We have got like, this is an enormous amount of exposition here, right? I feel like authors are generally discouraged from putting so much exposition. It's like this huge info dump. Anyway. Where were we?
谁的责任呀？办教育的人只怨社会黑暗，而不记得他们的责任是使社会变白了呢？不记得他们的人格是黑夜的星光。还有什么希望？我知道我的太偏，我是太偏，太理想。但是办教育的人是否都应当有点理想？我知道政府社会太不帮忙他们了。但是谁愿意帮忙与政府社会中一样坏的人？你看见了那宰杀教员的，先不用 敬意。那是没人格的教育的当然结果。教员没人格，学生自然也跟着没人格。不但是没人格，而且使人们倒退几万年，反回古代人吃人的光景。人类的进步是极慢的，可是退步极快。一是美人格，人便立刻反归野蛮。况且我们办了200年的学校，在这200年中，天天不是校长与校长或教员打，不是。便是教员与教员或校长打，不是学生与学生打，便是学生与校长教员打，打的会使人立刻变成瘦的。 打一次便多一点野性，所以到了现在，学生在几个校长或教员是常见的事。
All right. So this kind of dissection, maybe that was from my perspective. So what's happening is there's this complete failure of the education system, and people are becoming more primitive, and so on, more barbaric, and dissecting their teachers.All right, so just pause for a second. All right, where were we?
Yeah, 学生有朝一夕，有朝一日，也必变成校长教员。
All right. Don't worry about the people being dissected. The people performing the dissection will be the ones being dissected one day, basically. That's a bit of a weird way of thinking about it.
自由人在原来在杀他们。好在多几个这样的校长教师与社会上一点儿关系没有，学校里谁杀谁也没人过问。在这种黑暗社会中，人们好像一生出来变小野兽似的，东闻闻，西抓抓，希望搜寻到一点可吃的东西，一粒沙大的一点便宜。都足使他们用全力去捉到。这样的一群小人们恰好在学校里遇上那么一群教师，好像一群小恶兽遇见一群老恶兽，他们非用爪牙较量不可了。贪小便宜的欲望消极有原人移下来的野性，于是为本书一个迷眼都可以打得死尸满地。
So even over small things that these people are going to, are willing to kill her. All right. Yeah, so, like, everyone's full of corruption and they're starving and it's like, I need to eat something. My teacher is looking tasty. I like Chinese food. Or in this case, it's cat food. Sorry, that's a bit of a dark humor all of a sudden.
Nao feng chao shi qin nian xue xing de ji dong shi you ke yuan liang de dan shi wo men ci chu de feng chao shi ling you feng wei de jie ti mu nao qi lai chai's first turn, right? Chai fengzi hui dong xi. 而后大家往家里搬砖石破烂。
This is a chungi, right? 搬砖石破烂. This is like borrowing from Peter to pay Paul. Like, oh, that part of my house needs repairs. So I take this part of my house to repair that part of my house.
心满意足，家长也皆大欢喜。因闹风潮而家中白的了几块砖，一根木棍。风潮总算没有白闹。校长教师是得机会就偷东西。 学生是借机会就拆毁完了王家里搬运。校长教师该死。
This is not a swear word, it's like, yeah, they deserve to die. Yes, they deserve to die. What was that? It's a Samuel L. Jackson quote. What was that movie?
学生该死，学生打死校长教师，正是天理昭颖。等学生当了校园教师，又被打死，也是理智当然。这就是我们的教育。 教育能使人变成野兽， 不能算没有成绩，哈哈。
All right, so I'm guessing this radically warped education system where students get an immediate graduation from high school for university for free, and they become barbaric to the point where they're eating their teachers and principals and so on. And then they become principals and teachers themselves, and their students eat them. And then they kind of use this kind of like credential to get further in life. I guess this is some kind of satire of like early 1900s China and politics at the time. I'm guessing that's what it is. Somewhere around that time, late 1800s, early 1900s. All right, time for a rest, since we've finished the chapter. All right, thank you for watching. Let's call it a video. Remember to like, subscribe, do the usual YouTube things, and I'll see you in the future. That's it, y'all. Bye-bye.